Target dollar spot. They have a lot of Memorial slash 4th of July stuff out in their dollar spot. They also have a ton of really, really cute summer stuff. I tried to control myself from purchasing the entire dollar section. If you guys know me and have been watching me for a while, you do know I'm obsessed with Target. I am there mostly every week, multiple times a week, and I buy so much stuff from them. I hope, you know, one day in the far future they will sponsor me because I buy so much stuff from Target. And I did pick up a few things from their dollar spot. I picked up some stuff for Ryan because we're gonna do like a little scavenger hunt. I'm trying to do fun stuff for summer, so I picked up some stuff for summer for him. And then we're also going to do a lemonade stand with his friends, so I picked up a few items for that and just other stuff that I thought was really cute and decided to pick up. So let's jump right into this haul and I will share with you guys everything that I have purchased. But first, let me get another sip of my coffee, guys. It's almost 5 o'clock. It's like 4:30, 4:40, and I needed coffee. I needed a little pick-me-up. So yeah, I'm drinking coffee at 4:40 in the afternoon, but it's okay. All right, guys, let's start off with this really cute lunchbox. Now, this was $3, and you would think I probably picked this up for my kids. No, I picked this up for myself because I am always throwing my snacks in the kids' lunchboxes, and I decided to get myself my own so I can throw my snacks in here and then separate their snacks because a lot of times when they see mine, they want mine. So I thought this was really cute. It's insulated inside, so it'll keep my food nice and cool. And I don't know, I just thought it was really cute. It has a bunch of different like little strawberries on it and then has some flowers. So I picked this up for myself. And then going on with the strawberry theme, they had these really cute napkins. I always buy these napkins from Target and put it on my coffee slash tea table. So this was only $1, so I grabbed that. Also always buying straws to put on my coffee tea bar. So I decided to buy 3 packs and I honestly wanted to buy more, but I told myself I didn't need it. So I only stuck with 3. This first pack is like a baby pink with a bunch of strawberries on it. And all these straws were only $8 each. This pack comes with 24. And then I found these. They are also paper straws, but they have watermelons on it. So cute. So these only come with 6 and they were $1 as well. And then another pack of same exact ones as the watermelon one, except they are strawberries and they also come with, I believe, 6. Yes, 6. And they have a bunch of other really cute straws like for 4th of July and just a bunch of other designs. But I thought 3 packs was good enough, so I just grabbed those 3. Next, I bought a few things for Father's Day. They do have a bunch of really cute stuff for Father's Day out in their dollar spot. So hopefully my husband isn't watching this because he's going to see one of the things he will be receiving for Father's Day. But I thought this was really cute. First, I bought him this card. There was another card that had like a golf theme in the front and I was going to buy him that one because he loves golf. But Ryan picked out this one, so I decided to just grab this one because this is what Ryan wanted to get him. And it just says, best dad ever. And Ryan says he wanted to buy him this one because daddy is a builder. So that's the card that we got him and it was only $8. And then I just bought this tissue paper. This tissue paper was $3, but it comes with a lot. It comes with 50 sheets. And then it has white, blue, and then this white one says hero, papa, father, grandpa, dad, hero. So just really cute to put into his gift bag. And then I also picked him up this slim power pack. They had another one that was like a keychain one and was like leather. I wasn't getting that one, but I wasn't sure if he would actually put it on his keychain. So I just grabbed this one. He always loses these. He's had a ton of these and for some reason he's always losing or breaking them. So I picked him up this one. It's just in black and this was $5 and it just says it's a slim power pack so he can charge his phone. Now the next few things is going to be for the kids' lemonade stand. They will be doing a lemonade stand with their friends. So me and my friend decided to just split it down the middle. She bought half of the stuff for the lemonade stand and then I bought the other half. So this isn't all of the stuff that will be on their lemonade stand. Like I said, she bought half of the stuff and then I bought half. This is just what I purchased. So the first thing is going to be this little tin jar. It was only $1 and it says tip jar. So we will put this on the table for the kids. Then I bought a pack of cups. They were only $1 for 12 and they are 7 fluid ounces. And it's just white cups with like yellow stripes on it. And then we decided that we would do cookies with the lemonade. So I bought 2 packs of these little snack treat bags. They are each only $1 and they come with 22 treat bags each. So this one is just clear with lemons, and then this one says easy peasy lemon squeezy. So really cute, just snack bags that we're gonna throw the cookies in. And this is how the clear one looks like with the lemons. And then I picked up this little chalkboard easel. It says fresh lemonade. This was only $3. So I thought that we will just set this up on their table and write their names on here, and then how much the lemonade and how much the cookies are going to be. So I thought that was really cute and really good for only $3. And the last item that I purchased for the lemonade stand is a yard sign. It was only $3. Can't really tell because of my lighting, but it says fresh lemonade, so we would put this in the yard. The next few things is going to be for Ryan. I decided to do a little scavenger hunt for him outside. I don't know when we're gonna do it because this Georgia weather is bipolar. One minute it is thunderstorming and the next minute it's sunny. So I did pick up a few things for that. And the first thing is this adventure vest. It was $5. They had a bunch of different designs. He liked this one the best. It's blue. And then it says adventure awaits. So I'm going to make him put this vest on while we are doing the little scavenger hunt. What are you doing? Here, we'll play with that. And then I found this little scavenger hunt list pad. I thought was really cute for only $1. And it says backyard scavenger hunt. And he basically has to find everything that is on this list. So there's a butterfly, a snail, flowers, a three-leaf clover, a frog. So just a bunch of different things that he would have to find in the backyard or even in the front yard. So I thought that was really cute, and he can check it off once he finds those items. Next thing I found was this backyard safari kit. And there's just a bunch of different animals in here. There's a lion, hippopotamus, elephant, rhinoceros, and a crocodile. So I thought I would just hide all those animals somewhere in the backyard, and then he will have to go and find them. And then there's like little check boxes so he can check off each one once he finds it. And then what I really like about it is it also gives you some information on each of the animals so he can learn about each animal once he finds them. The next thing that I found was this play sand and bugs, and this was $3, and I thought this would be really good for Madison as well for her sensory. So what I plan on doing is getting a larger bucket, putting all the sand in that bucket, and then hiding all of the little bugs in it, and having Ryan scavenger hunt and look for all the little bugs. And then I'm gonna go online and print out information about each bug. So just like with this backyard safari kit, once he finds each insect bug, then we can learn a little more about each bug. So I thought that would be a really cool thing to do as well for the little scavenger hunt. And then I found this dino grow egg. Ryan's obsessed with dinosaurs, and this was only $1. So I thought that was a really good deal. So I thought all the way at the end of his scavenger hunt, I will hide this somewhere in the backyard. And then when he finds it, then we can bring it inside and place it in water. It says it takes 48 to 72 hours for the dinosaur to grow. So he can watch the little dinosaur hatch and grow. So I thought that would be really cool. So this egg is green, and I'll probably do that as the last thing for his scavenger hunt. And then the last thing I found that I thought we can do on another day, maybe when we're outside playing with bubbles and chalk, is this prehistoric geyser. It says see what you can do with a soda and Mentos. This was $3. So basically you buy a 2 liter of Diet Coke, you put the Mentos inside of this little plastic tube, screw it onto the soda, and then it's supposed to be like a science experiment, and it's supposed to explode into the air, if you guys can see in the picture right there. So I thought that would be a really cute science experiment to do at home, and I thought he would really, really love it. So depending on how well this works, then I will go back to store and buy some more Mentos and just reuse the tube. Hopefully I can reuse the tube and do it again. So that is the last item that I purchased from Target's Dollar Spot. If any of you guys have kids, then I really think you guys should check out Target's Dollar Spot. They have so many cool and cute, fun kid stuff for the summer. A lot of this stuff is really educational, like this backyard safari kit. He gets to learn about each animal when he finds it. This is a science experiment. So a lot of this stuff is educational, which I really, really like. So yeah, that is going to end my Target's Dollar Spot haul. Hopefully you guys enjoy this haul. I'm going to try and vlog once I do all this. So I will try to vlog when we do our lemonade and cookie stand. And then I will also vlog once Ryan does his little scavenger hunt in the backyard and probably his little science experiment. So you guys can see how well this works out and how well this science experiment works out as well. So like I said, hopefully you guys enjoyed today's shop with me and haul. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. And if you would like to be notified anytime I upload a video, then remember to hit that notification bell so you are notified anytime I upload my videos. Like always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.